Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my channel. Today, in this video, we are going to discuss a class 10 English chapter, The Girl Who Was Annie Frank's question and answers. And this is part 2 of the question and answer session. The part 1 is already uploaded in the channel and the description of the same and the lesson explanation video will be shared in the link in the description box for your convenience. So let's move on to the question and answers. But before that, students, if you're viewing my video for the very first time, do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you get the notifications of all the upcoming videos. Do watch the video till end, and if you like it, hit the like button and do not forget to share it with your friends. So let's move on to the question and answers. We were discussing comprehension questions. Answer briefly the following questions. First 14 questions is being done in part 1. So let's continue with the 15th one. How did Annie compare herself to a songbird? Answer is, Annie felt like a songbird whose wings had been brutally torn out and who was flying in utter darkness against the bars of its own cages. She wrote, when she had been isolated from the outside world for nearly 16 months. Okay. So here, why did Annie compare herself to a songbird, a bird which is always caught in a cage? So here she felt that she is like a songbird because she is comparing herself to a bird whose wings have been brutally torn out or cut out and it's not able to fly. It's just inside the cage against the bars in utter darkness. The life is full of darkness. She cannot go out. She is comparing herself like in this manner with the songbird. Thus she wrote this, and she wrote this when she had been isolated. Means she had been kept aloof from the outside world. There was no contact with the outside world as before, and like this they were staying for nearly 16 months, for 1.5 years. Literally they were isolated from the outside world, and that is when she wrote and compared herself to a songbird and wrote this thing. Moving on to the next question. What does Annie reveal about her mother in the diary? Answer, Annie reveals her grief because she feels that her mother does not understand her. These thoughts are penned in her diary. So we get to know the information that is revealed, that is opened up by Annie, is that her grief, she so shows her grief, her sadness, because she feels that her mother doesn't understand her. Because we have earlier seen that the people pretend to think that her elder sister Margaret was more brilliant and active than Annie. So were the family members also. So she feels that grief, she has that sadness that the mother is not understanding her. And these thoughts are penned, means it's written in her diary by herself. Okay. Moving on to the next question. How does Annie try to keep the diary a secret? We know that Annie kept her diary as a secret. She did not show or share it with anyone. How did she do this? Answer. On a slip of paper, Annie wrote faked names which she intended to use in a case of publications. Annie wanted to keep the diary a secret from everyone, so she used to hide them in her father's briefcase. Okay. Because she did not want it to show it to everyone, she also hided her name. She wrote, she penned her fake names while she wrote something on a slip of paper. And she thought, she intended that she will use this name if her diary gets published someday. So she had written her fake names there. So this is one thing which shows that she tried to keep secret. And the next thing is that she wanted to hide her diary from everyone. She did not want it to share to anyone. And thus she used to hide it in her father's briefcase, from whom she had taken permission to keep it there. Okay. So this is how she managed to hide her diary or keep it as a secret. Then next question. Pick out from paragraph 16 two examples of the inhuman treatment of the Jews by the Nazis. Answer. The Jews were carried in the cattle trucks to Auschwitz, the Nazi death camp in southern Poland. The men and women were placed in separate camps and tortured so much that most of them died of exhaustion. Okay. So here, while we read paragraph 16 from the chapter, we come to know that the Jews were carried in the cattle trucks, how the cattle have been carried. So in the similar manner, they were just filled in the trucks and carried to Auschwitz. And that was the Nazi death camp, which was located in southern Poland. And the men and the women were separated there in the camps, and they were tortured so much that they died of the exhaustion and the torture which had been done on them. Okay, so from this, we can give the examples of the inhuman treatment done by the Nazis. Okay, moving on to the next one. Why does the writer call Annie a courageous leader? Answer: Annie proved to be a courageous leader of her small Auschwitz group. When there was nothing to eat, she dared to go to the kitchen to ask for food. She constantly told Margot never to give in. Okay, so these were the things or the qualities which made the writer to call Annie a courageous leader. When she was in the Auschwitz group, she proved as herself as a courageous leader, because when there was nothing to eat, she dared herself to go to the kitchen and ask for food there. And she constantly told her elder sister Margot also never to give up. Okay, that is why she could be called as courageous leader. Next question. Paragraph 18 gives a vivid picture of Annie's last day in the concentration camp. Pick out all the details of her pathetic physical state. Answer: Later in autumn, Annie and her sister were transported to Belsen, another camp between Berlin and Hamburg. She was old, hungry, her head shaved on her almost skeleton body, dressed in the coarse, shapeless, stripped garb of the concentration camp. She was pitifully weak, her body racked by typhoid fever. She died early in March 1945, a few days after Margot. Okay, so from paragraph 18, we get this different picture of Annie, that later in autumn, Annie and her sister were transported to Belsen. And it is another camp which is situated between Berlin and Hamburg. And here she is being said to seen as very old, hungry, and her head was shaved, and almost skeleton body she had. And it was dressed in a shapeless, stripped clothing of the concentration camp. Garb is nothing but clothing. Okay, stripped, how the prisoners wear the dress, in the same way she was in the stripped garb of concentration camp. She was pitifully weak. She had become very weak. The body was in pains by typhoid fever. And she died early in March 1945. It was few days just after her sister Margot's death. So this is how the vivid picture of Annie's last day has been highlighted in paragraph 18. Moving to next one. When and where did Meep find Annie's diary? Answer: May found Annie's diary when she boldly returned to Annex a week after the Frank family had been arrested. Okay, so we have read the chapter and we came to know Meep, one who was a typist. She visited very boldly the Annex where the Frank family had been hiding for so many days, that Annex, that room. And there she found some of the Frank's diary which was there, the writings which were there, and she kept it safely. So this she did it. She went very boldly after the Frank family had been arrested. So this is how she found Annie's diary there, and she kept it safe. Next, question 22. The writer says that if Meep had read Annie's diary, she would have destroyed it. Why does the writer think so? Answer: The writer thinks that if Meep had read the diary, she would have found detailed information on the help she and other people had given the Frank family at the risk of their lives. And she might well have decided to destroy the diary for reasons of safety. Okay, so writer thinks that if Meep, the typist who got the diary, if she would had read the diary, she would have found the detailed information that Annie had written in that, about the help that she was providing and the other people also who were giving the help to Frank family, and that this help which they were giving at the risk of their own lives, even they were hiding and helping them. So when she would have read this, she would have got to know that there is any detailed information which we have provided, and she might have well decided to destroy the whole diary for the reasons of her safety, or else even she would have been punished. So that is why the writer says that if she would have read the diary, she would have destroyed it. Okay. So moving on to the next one. Why does Mr. Frank take many weeks to finish reading the diary? Answer. It took Mr. Frank many weeks to finish reading the diary, as he used to break down after every few pages, overcome by emotion and pain. Okay. So Mr. Frank, when he got the diary, when it was handed over to him, and when he started reading it, it took many days and many weeks for him to finish the reading the whole diary, because after every two pages he used to break down. Means he used to cry. He started crying because he was overcome by the emotion and the pain, the things, the thoughts, the feelings which were expressed in the diary by her daughter, and that made him very emotion and was in pain. Thus he was breaking down, he started to cry, and that was the reason he was not able to finish it fast, and he took many weeks to finish reading the diary. Next, what became the mission of Mr. Frank's life? The care of his daughter's diary had become his passion, his mission of life. Okay, so the care of the daughter's diary, what he has got, and the kind of affection and the love he had towards her daughter and the diary, that had become his passion, and that became his mission of life. The way that the people were responding to it, the way he was getting the letters and he used to reply to it personally. So there he made his passion and the mission of life. Okay. So this was the mission of Mr. Frank's life. Next one. How did Mr. Frank spend the money he got from the publishers? Answer. Mr. Frank spent all the money he got from the publishers as royalties on humanitarian causes, which he felt would have been approved by Annie. So here, Mr. Frank, whatever money he got from the publishers when the diary of Annie Frank was published, he just used that royalties, that thing, that money, the amount, as an humanitarian cause to serve the people, because he felt that even that would be approved by Annie. Annie would have liked doing this. So thus he spent all the royalties on humanitarian causes, and that is how he did it. Next one. How did the German audiences respond to the tragic play of Annie Frank? Answer. The German audiences responded to the tragic play of Annie Frank in silent remorse. People did not even go out during the interval. Okay, so the play of Annie Frank, which was converted into play and was played in various theaters, the German audience there, they responded to this play in such a silent remorse. Remorse means feeling guilty of something, of doing something wrong. So they felt so silent remorse, and they even did not go out during the interval, as if they were very afraid or fear or shameful to face each other. Okay, so this is how you can write the answer. Next one. How did the diary of Anne Frank succeed where German administrators had failed? Answer. The post-war administrators had toiled for years to make people realize the senseless and criminal nature of Nazi regime, but they had failed. The diary of Annie Frank succeeded in doing what the administrators had failed to do. So after the war, administrators of Germany, they had toiled, they had worked very hard for years to make the people realize that the act which was done was very senseless and was criminal in nature by that Nazi regime. But they had failed. They could not bring that to the people. They could not keep it in the form they wanted to. But the diary of Annie Frank, it succeeded in doing that what the administrators had failed to do from so many days. Okay, next, last question. Why did the people of Berlin choose her name for Annie Frank home? Answer. In West Berlin, an Annie Frank home was opened, devoted to social work for young people. The people of Berlin chose her name for Annie Frank home because she symbolized the spirit of racial and social tolerance. Okay, so in Berlin, and Otto Frank and Annie Frank home was opened on her name, and it was devoted to social work for young people. They were working like as an organization where they wanted to help people and the society, and the people of Berlin chose her name to keep it as Annie Frank home because she symbolized, she had become a symbol of spirit and emotion of racial and social tolerance. Thus, they kept the name Annie Frank home. With these few questions, we come to the end of this question answer session. I hope this video was interesting and informative for you all. If it was informative, do hit the like button and share with your friends. I'll be soon back with the rest of the question answers of the chapter. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.